Father and our God, we come before you in the name of Lord Jesus Christ, whom we remember on this Palm Sunday. In Psalms 24, King David said that, "Lift up your heads, your gates be lifted up, ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in." Yes, Lord, we lift up our heads, gates, and hearts, so that the King of Kings, Sovereign, Mightiest, Passionate King may come in. Yes, Lord, we accept our authority on us, we accept our sins, we surrender ourselves to you, we empty our heart to invite you. Lord, you know the current situation of our country and world. Please deliver us from this. We are not able to assemble on your holy sanctuary to worship you. Lord, you are the God who shed your holy blood on cross to heal us. We claim the holy blood of Calvary. Please save our world and country from coronavirus. Lord, we are praying for doctors, nurses, and paramedical staff who are serving the victims day and night. We pray for their families. We remember our Sunday school and our church elders, church members. Protect them, bless their families. Give us nice wisdom and knowledge. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Oh, she's God, glory to God. It's a great pleasure to get connected to you through WhatsApp after two Sundays for the general session. Children, do you know what is special today? It's not a general Sunday. Yes, today is Palm Sunday. Do you remember? Every year, we'll take the procession round the church with the palm leaves, decorated with the flowers and all, with the songs like Hosanna paadudam Yesu dasulara Yesayya messayyaku unnathamandu Hosanna. Yes, children, today is Palm Sunday. Let us look into the Bible. Before going into the story, let me quote a sentence. Being crucified like a criminal, he rode into the city like a king. Interesting seniors. He was crucified like a criminal on Good Friday. On Palm Sunday, he rode into the city, Jerusalem, like a king. How he rode, let us see. So, when we'll open our Bibles, in Matthew 21, the Bible speaks. Matthew 21 verses 1 to 9. Yes, Jesus, last journey, last week on earth, he rode into Jerusalem on the donkey. So when he started journey, he said to his two of his disciples to go into the town and untie the donkey and get it. And he's given the instructions to the disciples. When you'll go to the town, when you'll try to open the town, the people of the town will put you a question. For what purpose you are taking this donkey? That time, you be good enough. Give the reply that this donkey is for Jesus. When he has done with this, he'll get it back to you. Yes. Disciple is nothing but they are the followers. They have followed what the Jesus said. Yes. Today, we have to follow what the Bible is saying for us. Either it may be the Ten Commandments, fruits of the Spirit, Beatitudes. We have to go according to that. Whatever the Bible is teaching, whatever we are learning every Sunday in the Sunday school. Yes, children. So, let us come back to the story once again. Jesus started the journey on the donkey to Jerusalem. Disciples were ready enough to remove the upper garments, the cloaks, long garments, to put it on the donkey. Jesus sat on that. The people started running, coming to Jesus. We don't know how it spread the news that Jesus was on the way to Jerusalem. That time, they didn't have the internet, Wi-Fi, WhatsApp, nothing was there. But everyone today, Corona, news update, how many death cases? We'll be waiting for the news update through Wi-Fi. Yes, but that time, they didn't have anything. How the message spread? In Luke's Gospel, when we were getting ready for TMR exams, Luke's Gospel, full of miracles. He has given the sight to the blind. He touched the lepers. He raised the dead. Through that, people came to know about Jesus. He became very famous. Everyone started running to Jesus. Who didn't have the cloaks? They ran to the fields. They cut down the palm branches. They put the branches down. And the donkey was walking on that. Jesus started the journey. Children, do you remember? Annual day, sports day, we'll put the green carpets for the guest of honor we receive. How? With the pom-poms, with the flower petals. In the same way, Jesus has been received today to Jerusalem with the praises. How they praised? Hosanna, Hosanna, behold, he's the one who is coming. Yes, they started shouting, Hosanna, Hosanna. Behold, he is the one who is going to come. Yes, children. And what the palm branches represents? The victory, the triumphal entry. What the donkey represents? It's a symbol for peace. Hebrew word Hosanna means save us. Jesus has come into this world to save us, to give the peace. He has a victory over the death. Yes, children. When he entered into the Jerusalem, people couldn't recognize him. They were busy in their training. Jesus' heart was paining a lot. Yes, this is the time for us, the Palm Sunday. is the time to get our hearts repaired for the agony of his passion and the victory, the joy of his resurrection. Let us cover the road to the cross with our hearts, mind and soul. So before closing the general session, let us look back into the memory verse. You can open your Bibles. Matthew 21 verse 9. Behold, he is the one. Children, this memory verse, Anjali Akka is going to teach for you.
The memory verse, that is Matthew 21:9. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Matthew 21:9. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Matthew 21:9. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Matthew 21:9.